We'll be right back. Welcome to the 12th IKF Crossboard World Championships and a match between India and Ireland. Please welcome the team from India.
Let me touch down. First, the captain, number 11, Nitesh. Number 3, Shilpa. Number 1, Vishal Sharma. Number 4, Indu Bala. Number 12, Pranav Popatkovne. Number 9, Balwinder Kaur. Number 14, Hani Nehra. And number 10, Tamanna Kumari. And the coach, Rajesh Kumar Seni.
Please welcome the team from Ireland. First, the captain, number 10, James Norman. Number 2, Lena Dury. Number 8, TJ Frost Bryan. Number 6, Charles Brown. Number 14, Lucy Kennedy Duong. Number 7, Elizabeth Tai. Number 31, Sam Gilvin. Number 15, Rebecca Oliver. And the coach, Keith Vernoven. Please welcome the referee for the match. Barry Van Ziegel from Netherlands. Wing Huang Li from Hong Kong, China. Chen Zhiwei from Chinese Taipei. And a jury for the match, Nina Jane Grace. Please stand for the anthem of India. And now the anthem of Ireland.
Oh, Hello everyone and welcome to the World Championship Korfball coming to you from Taipei City 2023. My name's Tom Brady. We're here to see Ireland against India in a game which will hopefully set up a clash against Thailand, where they're playing for the 17th place on the last day. Now, both teams have been in the World Championship before. Ireland only once, but this is India's 7th World Championship. Their best result in 1999 was 11th. Ireland placed 16th in 2019. Not much in the team rankings for them, but they've both had a mixed journey through the tournament, which obviously means that the best that they can do at the moment is 17th. However, the beauty of the later stages of the tournament is that the teams are at equal level. We're going to see a good game today. I'm expecting...
3, 2, 1,
commentating on India yesterday, and they played some very interesting rebound defense tactics. Very advanced, actually, you know, considering the world ranking that they've got. Ireland can be pretty clever as well. They've got Terry Ford at the post, who's a bit of a wizard. They've got Case Verhoeven, you see him there in the middle. He's their coach. Now, disclosure, I played for Ireland for many years. So in a game I'm not commentating on, I'd love to see them win. But I'm going to do my best to be fair to this India team. I like what I've seen from them so far. I want to see a good game. I want to see good goals. And I want to see the best team win. And that's the beauty of korfball, is that the best team normally always does win. Now, the referees for today holding the ball there is Muriel van Zogel-Folen from the Netherlands. And down the other end will be Chung Hung Lee from Chinese Taipei. Very experienced international ref. You'll know him from many other games, you international players. It's India in white. It's starting in attack. I'll talk you through who we got. It's Balvinder Kaur, Sharma Shilpa. That's Kuman Katil Shilpa with the first Indian shot, and they get a retention through Sharma Vishal. And he muscles his way past, I think that was Sam Galvin, and drew a penalty. Good start from India, first attack on the penalty line. Ooh, doesn't go. He goes for the tip back, and it was defended. Sometimes that's a penalty when the player's following through. Standard of refereeing has been fantastic. I'm pretty much going to trust everything that these referees say to me today, using their whistle for the talking. James Norman, Chelsea Brown, TJ Fraser-Byrne. Wow, good early shot. James Norman comes over the top of Nitesh, the Indian captain. I'll talk a lot about him today. I think he's a bit of a character. Leanne Jury takes the shot, and there is Nitesh. He's only got one name within the database, so I wish I had one in my database. So he'd be very recognizable when you see him. Balvinder Kaur, I think that's driving on, I'm assuming that was Lizzie Tai. India making it difficult for Ireland to get it out, but they do nice and smoothly in the end. James Norman, early post position. Chelsea Brown's pass into the post, easily picked off by Honey Nera. Pamain Papat in the feed, now shooting the little shot, now scoring the little shot. Good start from India. Sharp moves around the post. Chelsea Brown will shoot well from the outside. Leanne Jury happy to shoot nice and early. James Norman collecting easily. Norman just steps out nice and calm, takes a beautiful shot, scores a beautiful goal. Ball coming from the side from TJ Fraser-Byrne. And it's Chelsea Brown just going down. Oh, looks in a little bit of pain. We're on something like day 8 of the tournament. These players have got a lot of games in their legs at the moment. They don't want to see an injury to Chelsea Brown. She's been a main player for them, or one of the main players coming through the tournament, which she's certainly been on the pitch most of the time. For me, the most exciting Irish players, but Lizzie Tai, you can't see her in your picture at the moment, but number 7, I'll be talking about her when we see her attacking again. Obviously some concern about Chelsea. Mm-hmm. Okay, he's going to be well looked after by the medical staff as Nitesh for India pulls his division together just for a few words, just keep them focused on what they're doing. Now, you may think, oh, they're only kind of like playing for 17th place, but all these games are special. All the attacks mean something. Every goal means something. And Chelsea's up now, and that's good for Ireland and good for the game. So Nitesh to Indu Bala, just jumping the gun a little bit. Oh no, Indu's going to start it. Indu a long way out, trying to work it round. Pressure from TJ Fraser-Byrne forces the turnover. Sam Galvin. And there's Lizzie Tai early into the shooting action, collected by Lucien Kenny-Dwyer. Other girl down there is Rebecca Oliver. She calls a two-handed running in shot over the head. Good goal from Ireland. That's Honey Nera. Oh, passing into Nitesh. Yeah, James Norman. Well, he doesn't think so. Referee had a very good view of that, and it kind of looked a lot like it from here. I don't think we're going to see a replay. Defenders always think they didn't foul. Nitesh scores, nice. Oh, this is going to be a close game, I think. And Leanne Drury just lets go of the ball, gives it back to India. And the shot from, I think, Shilpa. Okay, there's Chelsea Brown showing no ill effects as James Norman collects and takes the shot off the back. Nice early shot from Leanne Drury. Perhaps it's a little bit early. James Norman at the post, their captain, and I'm assuming division leader there. Maybe just telling her just to calm down a little bit, give him a bit of time to establish that position. In the meantime, the shot from Balvinder Kaur does reset, but the referee sees an infringement at the post. TJ Fraser-Byrne, his first shot, and it's a good one. Goes close, Chelsea Brown drives through, can't get the space. James Norman thought the ball was taken out of his hands. Shilpa, one-handed shot from range, picked up by Papad. Nice from Sharma Vishal. That is the symbol for knocking the ball out of the hands. And he's given a penalty. Lucien Kenny-Dwyer just letting his players know that he loves them and it's all okay. Looks like that's a necklace that didn't get picked up in the pre-game inspection. Referee Lee from Chinese Taipei must be very proud. Refereeing at home, wonderful tournament, great media attention. Semi-finals coming up later on today. I'll talk about that when the game gets quiet. And nice overhanded penalty from Kuman Katil Shilpa. TJ Fraser-Byrne in the feed to Chelsea Brown. Chelsea Van looking for the feed. James Norman's taken up the post this time though. And that's an easy interception for India. Nice drive from Shilpa. Call cutting. Chelsea Brown from range. Good shot. Nitesh competes, but James Norman comes away with it. Leanne Jury trying to stretch the division out to Chelsea Brown. Now they're getting a nice, beautiful 2-2. That's good play from Ireland. Switched the play from one side of the court to the other. Leanne Jury went and got it, and the timing of the feed from TJ Fraser Byrne was fantastic. Brings it back level. Wow. The one-hand bomb, the one-hand bomb from Honeynera. That's the way to answer. Lizzie Tai scored 11 in one game earlier on the tournament. Again, I think it was against Thailand. Kenny Dwyer chases that out, but can't get it back to Irish hands. Sam Galvin looks good from here from the camera position. I'm watching the same pictures as you. Lucy and Kenny Brown waits for Rebecca Oliver to come round. Eventually they get there, and it's Lizzie Tai is the one that they want to set up, quite rightly. Galvin stretches the play, and the shot from Kenny Dwyer. Galvin turns, it's a good turn, and a decent shot, bounces kindly for India. James Norman picks a good line, holds his ground, takes the charge. Nitesh, just a little smile and apology to his player. Good defending. And Kenny Dwyer has a quick look to see if he can pull his player, but Papat wasn't having it. Eventually they find themselves in the 2-2, and it's Sam Galvin that's going to be doing the shooting out there. Lizzie Dwyer wanted a feed, now it's there, but she's a little bit too close now. She's going to have to think about forcing one up. Can't see the shot clock from where we are. Just going to reset, but India get the ball. Great position, post position from Kenny Dwyer, and it will probably just deteriorate a little bit as the shot goes up, and he ends up out of position for the collect. Honeynera, that one-handed long shot, goes close again this time. Rebecca Oliver. It's even going to be more efficient running the block now, but Pomaine Papat, he just delays it by being clever, and the ball eventually finds its way back to Lucy and Kenny Dwyer. A good contest at the post, won by Pomaine Papat. Tamana High to Nitesh. Good golf ball. Kamari Tamana, number 10, into Nitesh. It scores a sharp goal underneath the corf. Leanne Jury, ever willing to shoot. TJ Fraser-Byrne, he's trying to stretch the division with the pass to Chelsea Brown, but it's easily intercepted. Shot from Shilpa will set up at least one last attack for Ireland. Shot clock and game clock or quarter clock are pretty level. They might just try and manage this time. No, they don't. TJ Fraser-Byrne's going to take that shot. They're going to get another one, though. If they'd held on to it, they would have. And now it's going to be India. But the challenge on the line. I'm sorry. Sam Galvin. He looks like he fell pretty heavily. He's got 8 seconds to negotiate. Okay, it's going to be a free pass, as it should be. Case for Hoven. He come and had a... Okay, look, he didn't influence the referees. I think he just wanted clarification of what it was, and he got it, and it's Ireland's ball. They get a chance to take what's going to be the last shot of the quarter, and they do take it. They do get a reset, and we got 2.63 seconds. Very accurate timing on this, and Chelsea Brown... That's going to be enough time for her to get the shot up and score a beautiful late goal for Ireland. Just going to bring them back to within one. Now, while the halftime's on, let me just whet your appetite about games coming up on the IKF channel. It's going to be semi-finals day today. And we got the Netherlands versus Czech Republic in the first semi-final. It's coming up after this game. Czech Republic beat Germany in an absolute classic. I didn't see the game described as the best game of the tournament. They're up against the mighty Netherlands. What can they do? Well, they can do their best is probably the answer that's going to come from that. And then the last game of the day, Chinese Taipei versus Belgium. Really, you know, if you love korfball, that's the sort of game that you've got to watch. Chinese Taipei, the home team. They've been great for years, but they're hitting top form now with their home tournament. And they're going to be fired up for that. I'm pretty much expecting the hall to be full. Belgium looking like they're playing with purpose and spirit. They're definitely the second best team in the world. And they'll be going hard. Definitely one to watch. That sound you hear is some substitutions coming on. I'm assuming unless occasionally the jury table does malfunction. But I think we'll see when we get down the other end that there are some substitutes on. Balvin de Cor trying to get some space, but it ends up with Katil Shilpa. She finds her way around, scores a running in shot. Rebecca Oliver just not quite sure, didn't seem to follow, gave up on it. Maybe she thought there was no chance of Shilpa turning that into a shot. Well, she definitely did. Rebecca Oliver. Is he tied? Sam Galvin looking for a feed, steps out and takes a well-timed shot. And that's a little bit sloppy from TJ Fraser-Byrne. Giving up the penalty to Honeynera. Who's like, did he step? Did someone encroach? Nitesh was close. Honeynera just trying to work out just exactly what happened there. Meanwhile, Sam Galvin gets 2 feet on the ground and takes a good shot. Galvin, beautiful shot. Ball coming out of the feed. Stand and deliver on the outside. Drops it down. Neither team able to establish much of a lead. Perhaps India looking just a little bit best at this moment. Interesting little ball there from Nitesh, looking for Honey Nera. Won't go. Nitesh will come off the post to take a high feed, and he does get it through to, I think that was a Tamana. It was defended in the end, and well defended. Good drive, Lizzie Dye. Turns it into a shot, but it just was a little bit off balance. Lucien Kenny-Dwyer's retained it, and they've got the perfect setup now. Lizzie Dye on the outside. Whoa, the triple bounce off the top when it comes out. And Nitesh trying to make something happen, and he just shoved James Norman out of the way. Referee is just sorting out. Both referees have equal status within the game. They generally put a little bit more experienced one with a less experienced one. But in terms of the game, they are completely level, and it works so well. Most serious leagues now looking to adopt the two referee system. Of course, Dutch Golf Ball League has had it for a long time now. Tamana. Nitesh, he's in so much of the action. There's Tamana again. Now Nitesh steps out. Norman was close, and close enough for the referee's liking. No complaints from Nitesh. Lizzie Tai. Good shot. Taking the responsibility for Arlis Sam Galvin. Saw his player coming. Oh, he turned it into a little shot. I think it was going to be a penalty as well. Went underhanded. We're back level again. And Kees Verhoeven, the Dutch coach, bringing on Daisy Tai now. Got some options on the bench, as both teams have. I think India have played a lot of the same players continuously. And Shilpa finds her way through illegally, according to the referee. The coach for India is Rajesh Kumarsani. Kept a quite consistent team starting, and they don't look too tired, so whatever he's doing is working for them. Chelsea Brown, nice. James Norman, tireless at the post. Leanne Dury, ever willing to shoot. Good contest won by Nitesh. Fraser Burn. Oh, Chelsea Brown. Oh, makes use of that well-timed feed from Fraser Burn. Beaten Kumari Tamana. Misses the running shot. Gets the consolation penalty. Good conversion with the overhand penalty. The overhand shot.
Time
we'll just go back for a timeout. Didn't hear from the announcer who it is. So I still think it is pretty balanced. India have got some interesting moves. They're not playing the radical rebound defense that they played the other day, but that's that was for a very specific game that they were playing. Ireland playing their typical game. They've got some people on the sideline, for example, like Terry Ford, who can really kind of do some damage when he comes on. He's a little bit older, might be a bit tired, but I dare say he's waiting in the wings if Ireland need him in this game. They've still got another match to come as well. And as when I used to coach international corfball, as you say to your players, win your last game. Win your last game and you put you on the plane home just a little bit happier. However, winning this match is going to lift them up for that chance at the 17th. Papat attacking well, but illegally, it wasn't Papat, it was Shamash Vishal. Illegally, according to the referee, for the charge. Good defending from Ireland. Leanne Jury to Chelsea Brown. Nice ball, nice shot, nice goal.
Number six, 12-6.
Okay, after being behind, Ireland now got their neck in front and they stretched it to two, and that's just a little bit ambitious from Nitesh. Always try and catch your opponents napping after a goal, but couldn't connect. Sam Galvin offers the feed. Oh, he gets a wonderful turning shot. Wonderful goal. Ireland now starting to take control. Downtown shot from Honey Nera is well picked up by Tamana. Nitesh is high in the feed, but the girls are going to have a run. And once again, is it giving it against Ireland? I thought that was another charge by Chelsea Brown. She's not complaining. Honey Nera. Okay, referee's just trying to just cut down on some of the contact, quite rightly. Let's see the corfball dominate. James Norman is in there. Well read, well timed his drive out from defence. Good pressure. Lizzie Tite comes and gets the ball. Kenny Dwyer will hold out strongly at the post. Marcel Galvin drops his fourth one in from range. He's on fire today. Ireland really taking control of this game. What can India do now just to try and spice things up? What they can do is they can shoot with Belvinder Kaur shooting from the sidelines. TJ Fraser-Bird got on the right side of his player, took a little shove. Chelsea Brown, smooth, nice. Percentage is good. She thought she had the follow through on her by Indu Bala. Vishal. Shoots from range. Papat does well at the post. Now the setup in the feed. And it's going to be Shilpa. No, it's going to be Kaur. And it's going to be Ireland at the post in the form of Kenny Dwyer. Chelsea Brown driving, can't get any space from a defender. Oh, but the referee's seen an infringement there. Kumari Tamana just holding her off. We'll put her on the line. Percentage in the game so far that I've seen has been great. And she looked very smooth there. Doesn't need to go far with the speed of her shot, and the extension on it is great. Scores her, I think that's her fourth. Tamana chases it down. Still plenty of time in the shot clock, but they just need to just increase the ball tempo at the moment. No collect. James Norman quite rightly holding Nitesh out. there was no stopping Kumari Tamana. One-handed shot from range again. Great to see their different corfballing styles. India fighting their way back into this game. And Daisy Tai gets round, takes a shot as we hear the call from the side for penalty. Referee's not having it. TJ Fraser-Burn trying to keep Honey Nera out, but Nera ends up on the right side of that collection. In the meantime, Tamana shoots again, and TJ Fraser-Burn ends up on the better side there. Lizzie Tai drives, round. God, that player just wasn't quite close enough. Still, the running in shot doesn't go. Papat just trying to make it difficult for Ireland to establish that second position close to the post. And shot from Galvin is well fought for. But it's Pomaine Papat's going to be the one that gets it. The referee just telling Lucy and Kenny Dwyer just to calm down a little bit. He was out of position, no chance to get the ball. Referees don't like that. In Dubala gets around, takes a running in shot. And they India have to foul to try and retain it, giving it back to Ireland. Lizzie Tye. Daisy Tye on the floor. Picks herself up, cleverly goes in and takes the feed position while Lizzie Tye shoots. And the referee's seen Pomaine Papat just using his leg at the post. Referees don't like that either. And just they've got the words there from the referee. Lizzie Tye, smooth, nice, beautiful. Ireland taking advantage of a little bit of an indiscipline from India, giving away free passes. Shot from Balvinder Kaur is eventually picked up by Sharma Vishal. His defender's on the floor, he takes his shot. Papat holds on to it. Oh, now it's going to be the boys. Balvinder Kaur. And looked like it was a charge. Yeah, charge on Daisy Tye. Daisy Tye picked a good line. Chelsea Brown, long way out. Nitesh, he does well. Doesn't get there. That's a quick look at the referee to see what he thought about the contact early on. TJ Fraser-Byrne, nice. Good contest, this time won by Norman. Chelsea Brown. Got the power. Nitesh follows gently this time. Sets up Leanne Drury. Good reset for Ireland. And good interception. Well, easy interception for Honey Nera. Tries to pass it deep. Sharma Vishal, smooth with his shot from the outside. India still in this. And you heard him on the side, 8 seconds. Ireland know what they have to do. Well, it's one shot, no time management. Chelsea's going to be the one. No, she's not. It's going to be Leanne Drury. Shoots closely. And that's the end of an interesting first half. I thought India started the better. Ireland kind of maybe just sorting out a little bit of their tactics and maybe read India's tactics a little bit well. Let's see what the impact is of these halftime talks. Come back and I'll speak to you in 10 minutes' time. I made the right selection.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Damn, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through. Then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place. How could we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began.
So
I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
When I see you again. First you both go out your way and the vibe is feeling stronger with small. Turn to a friendship turn to a bond. And that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. When brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn. And that line is what we reach, so remember me when I'm gone. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you're gonna be with me for the last ride.
Let the line guide your way.
Coming back for the second half of India versus Ireland. Remember, they're facing the winner will face Thailand in the next round, which is to be the final round, which is a playoff for 19th place. India started well. I think Ireland has perhaps worked them out a little bit better. India still playing with intensity and passion, though, and they pick up a nice, easy interception to start the half off. And Vishal just shepherds the ball out. and Ireland get the collection. Three goals is not enough to for Ireland to be thinking about the victory at the moment. This game is going to be won with goals, more goals. TJ Fraser-Byrne, little step, can't find space. Chelsea Brown too far out. Leanne Drury shoots pretty much everything, but the defender's there this time. Nice from Chelsea Brown. Good reset for Ireland. Bit sloppy from Fraser-Byrne, the pass in towards the post. They will retain it though. Chelsea Brown, easy for India. Girls attacking, no room this time for Shilpa. Now they go back and they'll try her again. Takes a good shot, good contest. Well won by Vishal. Oh, Popak, great feed. Pops the ball down to Shilpa. Running in shot doesn't go, but the penalty is called. I think that's against Sam Galvin by the indication from the referee. Taking the ball off the hand, no complaints. This will bring India back to two. These are big penalties now. And that one won't go. Pomaine Popat, little bit frustrated with himself. There'll be time for him to come back and be the hero of this game, though. Chelsea Brown, nice, beautiful. Defender not coming out, and Chelsea operating quite a long way out. She's got a lot of power. That's her fifth goal. Stepping up big today. Great run round for Kamari Tamana. Leanne Drury just, maybe Lord had just caught the referee's eye, and the referee felt the need to explain just exactly why that was a penalty. In the meantime, Kamari Tamana drops it down. Just India keeping back at the Ireland lead. Lizzie Tai, been the best player, I think, of the tournament, but it's Daisy Tai who takes the shot. And is the only one in this game so far. Sam Galvin holds. It's Daisy Tai the one that makes the space this time. And Lucien Kenny-Broward, he's in a better position. He had his hands on the ball. Pomaine Popat coming over the top. Took away the scoring opportunity, and Lucien Kenny-Broward gets his turn on the penalty line. He doesn't miss. Vishal, oh, nice, from range. Couldn't see anything else happening. He thought, I've got this, and he did have it. Brown, no chance for Norman at the post. Although he did. Nitesh is about to discover that he hasn't got that. Okay, now he knows. It is just a restart. Thumbs up. Okay. Boys on the inside. Leanne Drury on the outside. James Norman coming off the post. Good drive from Sharma Vishal, the outside jumping shot. Love that shot. Looks at an athletic player, Sharma Vishal. Good defending from India. But they give up the 2-2. And TJ Fraser-Byrne gets it through to Norman. Somehow off the bounce, it rolls off the top, and Nitesh is there to recover it. Oh, it's a referee injured. Okay, don't see this often. So the referee is Muriel Van Zolder-Fuhlen. Looks like she's going to come off in some distress, getting some attention from the Indian medical staff. Our reserve referee, Chi Wei Chen, from the Chinese Taipei I think is probably warming up at the moment. Okay, and yeah, look like the players, the referees deserve a little bit of time just to see if they can shake off an injury. The local medical staff are offering their support as well. Been a long tournament for the referees. Not saying that's why, but okay, so I wonder if they do the hooter for the Irish substitution. There's Paul Jeans, referees coordinator, just speaking with Muriel, just seeing if she's okay. Looks a bit distressed. Looks like she wants to go on. Of course she wants to go on. Okay, they're going to give her a chance. Yeah, good. So back to the action. It is India's ball. Sharma Vishal. I heard an Ireland substitution, and we'll talk about that when we see it. And there's Shilpa. Good moves. Daisy Tai. Just a little bit lackluster in her defense. Good moves from Shilpa. India back to two behind. They're knocking on the door, Sam Galvin. And now they've got an interception. Quick release. And Nitesh is there. Oh, what a great feed. What a wonderful ball coming from the other end. And Kumari Tamana seizes on the well-timed feed from Nitesh and tucks home the goal that brings them to only one behind. And that's a timeout. I'm not sure which team has called that, but Ireland will probably need a little bit of talking to. Looked like in control of the game at halftime, and suddenly now India are back to within one. Case for Hoven. Great coach. Coaches at PKC, Papendrecht Korfball Club. A club that I can personally thank. I'd like to personally thank for the generosity to many international teams. Ireland have trained there multiple times. I know other teams have. They've got wonderful facilities. And they're ever willing to host international teams and provide them with competition that they just can't get anywhere else. Obviously, it's a lot easier for European teams to access that kind of support from the Netherlands. And that's why I'm always rooting for teams like India, you know, and the Asian teams, not exposed to the opportunities that us European players have had or European teams. Oh, and India again. Is that a little bit of a limp on Sharma Vishal, number one? I hope not, because he's been one of their big players of the tournament. Honeynara into Nitesh. Oh, again! Tamana drives through. Girls are dropping now. The Ireland girls are dropping. And I think the Indian girls have put the fear in them. Oh, it's Terry Ford has come on and he gets his first collect. And that's sloppy. From Lizzie Tai, have Ireland lost their confidence a little bit? India on the ascendancy. Oh, there's nothing like momentum in any sport, but korfball is particularly like that. It can be so psychological, especially when you lose your confidence in your passing. Oh! There's players on the floor. Players running in, but well, anyway, the upshot is Ireland get it, and they end up in a nice 2-2. And Lizzie Tai turns awkwardly out of a shot. Now she finds herself underneath the court. She's still there, and she gets it kind of up, but it is defended in the end by India. And Nitesh calling up for the shot, controls it at the post. Good reset. Honeynara is the other boy. Nitesh controlling it, everything. Now he's feeding. Because the girls have no way again. Kumari Tamana is just breezing around her player. And now Leanne Jury has dropped off because of those running in shots. And it's going to allow Tamana to shoot from range and score in India. Oh, they've got the momentum, they're driving, they're the ones with the energy at the moment, and Ireland have to regroup somehow. It starts right here. James Norman. Terry Ford shows the shot. Wisely keeps it. Indian boys will switch to keep James Norman out of the post, but he eventually finds his way in there. Terry Ford is offering it to Leanne Jury, and he ends up with Chelsea Brown. Look, defended all the way. Islanders struggling. Good from Sam. Lucy and Kenny Brown, I think that was. Yes, it was. Kenny Dwyer, sorry. Now Norman in the post. Terry Ford on the outside, and he takes his first shot, and it's a good one. Lovely ball from Leanne Jury. Just gets Ireland going again. That will be good for the confidence. Good pass, good shot, good goal, and suddenly the game looks a little bit different. But still got the danger of the other division of India was just looking like they were dominating. Let's see what this division can do. Norman thinks about shooting, bobs it into Terry Ford. He wants the girls to run, okay? He wants them in to run the block. And Leanne Jury does, leaves Norman and Brown on the outside, and Norman takes the shot from a good range. Not bad, he follows it up. The flick to Terry Ford. Oh, and the fight from Norman, the commitment from the captain. Good ball from Leanne Jury. Just spreading the division. Again to Jury. Can it go now? No, but Norman is big and strong at the post against Nitesh. Shot clock ticking. And in the end, India come up with the ball just as the shot clock was under a second. Shilpa wants in on the action. Now Belvinda Kaur. Come on, Katil Shilpa for range. India fired up. Yeah, good goal. And now that dangerous Indian attack is in position down the other end. And so we end up with a shot from Daisy Tai. Now Lizzie Tai working with Sam Galvin. Shoots from quite a long way, maybe outside of her normal range, but Lucien Kenny Dwyer fights hard for it. Now he goes in, takes strong position against Popat. They find Galvin, gives it back to Lizzie Tai. Now Galvin's in the feed, it's good corfball, but they're not getting the clear space except for Daisy Tai on the outside. Now the shot clock is gonna be pressuring them all. Lizzie Tai gets a shot up, gets the reset, and Daisy Tai chases it down and ends up with Sam Galvin. Frantic moments for both teams. Hands in from Shilpa. Gives away the free pass. Ireland shooting well from the free pass line. Yes! So, Ireland one up. But I'm loving this attack down here from India. I'm loving the girls. They're putting the fear into the Irish defenders. They need to get the ball into the post and get those girls running again, because look at Leanne Jury doesn't want to go out. Oh, there's... So the girls have switched, and now Tamana is being defended by Chelsea Brown, who's dropping up. Indu Bala gets the shot up. Good attacking from India. Well, aggressive attacking from India. Entertaining attacking from India. Kenny Dwyer at the post. Sam Galvin stretches the division. Holds it there for Lizzie Tai. Offers her the feed again. Gets it back now. Daisy Tai shoots on good rhythm and a good goal. Fantastic Ireland goal. This game is getting hot. As the quarter ticks down. That one's not going to go. Ireland are going to retain it. They might squeeze up some sort of shot out of this. And they've got to try. They've got to get there. They've got to release it. They need the extra shot. It's not going to happen, though. As three-quarter times come, that was an exciting quarter of corfball. Ireland started the quarter in just wonderful position where it looked like they were going to start to dominate this game, start to run around with it. Wow, respect to India. They come back hard, in particular the Indian girls. They started attacking, they started being aggressive and driving through, not always hitting the running in shot. But what it does is it puts the fear into the defenders. The girls started dropping off, the Ireland girls started dropping off, and then really the structure of the defense was pretty much gone, and it was all India at times. There's Lizzie Tai, I believe. Yeah, looking calm, just listening to the coach. Big quarter of korfball coming up now. Just strong words coming from the Indian coach. That's Rajesh Kumar Sahni.
Fourth quarter.
Some England players have made their way into the crowd to support their Irish cousins. Big quarter of korfball coming up. Leanne Jury pops down. Nitesh happy to hold it. Terry Ford now, of course, starting to pressure India, bringing the ball out of attack. One interception is good enough for all the effort that you're going to put into it. Belvinder Kaur puts it in. Now the girls go. Oh, Belvinder Kaur showed one side, showed the other. Fantastic from India. Belvinder Kaur just really, what a really stutter step. Where were these moves in the first quarter? James Norman, oh, gets in the air. Off to Terry Ford, and he shoots two from two. Game has really come alive. India looking fantastic, but Ireland just won't let them go. Well, won't let them get level. Yeah, I like it with Nitesh in there. He controls, he's like a general of the team. Now it's out to Tamana. Now it ends up with the collection, but no reset. And they're going to have to do something else. And Tamana shoots from range to get the reset. And the ball bounces kindly for England off the good challenge. All four boys involved in it. Oh, shot from Daisy Tai. Referee will have to stop that. So 16 seconds on the shot clock. Ireland won't get a reset for this. It's Sam Galvin playing so hard his shoe came off. Looks like he's got ankle protectors on. Most senior international players will have some sort of ankle protection. You see Lucien Kenny Dwyer has some on as well. Not sure if the Indians have. Sometimes it's hard to see. Korfball pretty hard on the ankles, pretty hard on the shoes as well. Look at Sam Galvin, he's no ill effects, losing his shoe, he shoots down from range. Ireland have got their mojo back, they're punching the air. India not finished though, I think. Honey Nera, oh fantastic. They've all got the hot hand now. Ford has been a good addition to the division since he come on. Shooting well, so they're going to keep him out. Norman's going to go to post. Ford shoots well. Norman collects well. Chelsea Brown gets round. Scores a beautiful running in shot. Now it's Ireland in the ascendancy. They've got the momentum. But like I say, I don't think India are finished yet. Four. That's Vishal. Yes, good, stretches the ball out to Shilpa. Shilpa shoots. A rare miss shot for this stage of the game. They've all been so hot, and Pomaine Papat just touches the outside line. I was just actually thinking about Muriel. Muriel, the referee, has managed to continue, which is good. Even referees can feel the pain and run through it. Okay, India should let this go, really. Okay, boys on the inside. Terry Norman showed the shot. Now Terry Ford easily gets into the post. Shot from Leanne Jury. Won by Terry Ford. He's in space. He likes it. James Norman stretches out under pressure. Not defended. Oh, James Norman gets it back from Terry Ford. Gives it back in the ticky-tacky move. And Nitesh finally cleans it up and quickly distributes it to the Indian attack. Belvinder Kaur. Okay, trying the floaty ball over the top. And Sharma Vishal does well not to lose it. India now trying to force it in. Ireland boys recognizing they need to give their girls more protection by cutting out the feeds, and that's exactly what Lucien Kenny-Dwyer did there. Leanne Drury. Nice floaty ball to Ford, who quite rightly holds on. It gives around the back pass to Chelsea Brown, who gets it back again from Norman. And she shoots at Nitesh again. He's in there collecting, quick distribution, back into the Indian attack. Lucien Kenny-Dwyer, yes, once pushing in front of Popat to deny them that feed. They have to protect their girls, because the Indian girls are just looking deadly at the moment. Looking scary. High feed. Leanne Drury does find a way to trick a player. Chelsea Brown forces one up. Forces it in the court, more like. Big smile on the face. Why wouldn't there be? I think that's her seventh. Now I hope Ireland don't think about time management too early, for the sake of the game and for their sake as well, because you can sometimes lose a game just by thinking you've won the game if you can just run the clock down. But no, this is good hustle from Ireland. They need to hustle, because India aren't giving up. Galvin, yes, stands, delivers. Galvin wants it. Doesn't get it. It's going to be Lizzie Tye into Galvin. Lizzie Tye, oh, she has to step out a little bit from what started as a running in shot attempt. And Daisy Tye. Now Ireland are going to go full on blocking coming out, but it was pretty efficient from India. They still got time. Oh, into Nitesh. Oh, excellent. Moves from the captain. Daisy Tye. Popat. In the collect. And Tamana from range. Chelsea Brown, they say that the Irish defenders have switched, mainly because of the danger presented by Kumari Tamana. India just need to try and sort out how they're going to attack now with the Ireland girls dropping off. More outside shots is normally the way. Lizzie Tye. Oh, great. Her third of the game, she's finally got into her attacking rhythm. Not quite sure where that timeout is coming from. You know, it could be India going to discuss how they're going to get five back in 3 minutes. More likely it was Ireland and it was India. So yeah, so now they're trying to plan their strategy for how they were going to attack. If they get five goals in 3 minutes 41, not out of the question. On your screen there is the Ireland timeout. And Case Verhoeven, strong words with his team. Calm words from Coach Sahni for India. Just read the body language. Body language is still good. Body language from Ireland is always good. As the camera focuses on Lizzie Tye, just scored her third. Chelsea Brown leading the scoring now in the match with seven. Sam Galvin with five. Shilpa with four. And Tamana with four. Both teams shooting, scoring almost 60% of their goals through the girls. An inerrant shot. Collected at the back by Indubala. Indubala can't get around. That would have been pretty spectacular if that had a guy. It was a nice move in. Difficult scoop right-handed shot that close to the corf. Sam Galvin, nice, to Kenny Dwyer. Oh, is that it for Ireland? Galvin made the running, beat his player. Lucian Kennedy Dwyer drops that down. I think that's his second. Pop that post up. Give the girls a chance to run. Yeah, but that time Belvinda Kaur, I think she just runs into Lizzie Ty standing her ground. I think Ireland just have adapted their defense to this new invigorating attacking that we're seeing from India. And India just haven't quite readjusted their strategy yet. Clock's against them now. Ireland now starting to be patient. Terry Ford, Norman leaning a little bit on Nitesh, legally, of course. Well, not always, of course, but if the referee didn't call it, it's of course. Norman now in the free, good free, Chelsea Brown. Decent shot, good collection from James Norman. Now he'll sit in the free, and Chelsea Brown kind of turns the corner a little bit on the running in shot. Then a little bit of a look at the ref, nothing doing. Happy to have the reset though. Ireland are just collecting their way to victory at the moment. Now Chelsea Brown, turn of speed, and James Norman collects it, badges it out a few metres and takes a shot. Doesn't go close. What can India do now? I'm afraid these are only consolation goals, but maybe we can see some of the power these girls have been showing throughout the game. That's Shilpa. Yes. Close. And strong from Papan. He just getting called for using his legs in the challenge at the post. Daisy Ty coming off. Okay, going to see a number of substitutions. Ireland feel this is one now, and it definitely is. This division is still intact. All the players have come on down the other end. And that's a foul from Terry Ford. I think the ball from James Norman. Yes, James Norman just acknowledging. Yeah, okay, maybe I shouldn't have passed that. Sharma Vishal. Oh, Vishal, beautiful. And Papat gets the second bite of the cherry. And the second time of asking, Jonathan Wilson, number 9, just come on, he fouls, out of position. And Papat, oh, it's bobbled around a little bit, but they're happy to see it go in, they all count. That's his second goal. Drury, I'm glad she got a goal. She's really been tireless out there, taking responsibility, shooting. A lot of energy from India. Vishal wants it up, coming off the corf. Tuchel. Jonathan Wilson grabs it. Steve McDonough, number 12, is the other defender that's come on down that end. And I think Charlotte Wilson, number 4, also. Chelsea Brown had a great game. Top scorer of the game, Leanne Drury. Won't get it to go this time. Terry Ford has had a great impact on the game since he's come on. That's a good switch from Kamari to Manor. And yeah, called defended on what surely must be India's last shot. Ireland have won the game. They will go forward to play. Oh, no way. Terry Ford, downtown. Buzzer beater. I wasn't expecting that. He scored his third. Just doing my ramble. Ireland have won. I thought India started a little bit better. Ireland finally, I think, tactically worked out what India were doing. Respect to both teams. India, really, I enjoyed watching you play today. Some of the attacking, in particular by the girls, was a delight to see. Great to see such enthusiasm and such athleticism from both teams this late on in the tournament. I'm Tom Brady. Keep checking on the IKF YouTube channel. I believe the Netherlands versus Czech Republic is coming up very soon. Be sure not to miss that. Take care.